Hi everyone, Dennis Foley from Acoustic Fields. Today we're going to talk a little bit about some of the questions and comments I get into my inbox. I think this is number four in our series. So let's talk a little bit about some of the questions that we get. This one comes in all the time. I've built a room and I've used drywall. Well, you all know my feelings on that. We don't use it in any of our builds. Most of your top studio designers do not either. There's a reason for that, okay? And you got to get away from this thinking that cheap, you know, that there's not anything better. I get this all the time, especially this double drywall with green glue thing. But anyway, there's much better materials to use inside your room than drywall. Okay, get away from that thinking. Drywall has a particular sonic quality to us, and we're going to do some videos on that. We're going to actually do some measurements. I'm going to fire some speakers into some drywall. I'm going to fire some speakers into some other different materials, and we're going to measure the response. But stay away from drywall in your rooms. It's economical. It's cheap. But there are other things out there that don't cost much more or even less that work better. So when we'll talk about some of those. But stay away from drywall in your rooms. I can walk into a room right now and tell you it was made of drywall. I can just hear it. So, and you can too, if you really concentrate on it. What's some better materials to use? Simple plywood, veneered plywood is a good one. MDF is another good one. There's numerous other materials. And the other materials lend themselves to other applications that you may not be aware of, you know, vibrational control and things like that. So please stay away from drywall when you're building new rooms. If you have drywall in an existing room and you're really serious about sound quality of the room, we're going to cover it. Okay, here's another question we get all the time. Open versus closed cell foam. Open cell foam is the acoustical foam that we use. Open meaning that it has cells for energy to go in, bounce around within the cell structure, create friction, produce heat, cause a loss in energy. Okay, so closed cell foam is the foam that you use in your pillows, your cushions on your couch, the seats of your car, things like that. It's not really designed for acoustics. It's not designed for molecular velocity. It's not designed to change energy into heat through friction because there's no way for the energy to get inside of it because, as the name implies, it's closed. Now, there are some ways you can get closed cell foam to work for low frequency absorption. It's a little bit beyond this discussion here. So always, when you're dealing with absorption and you want to use foam, foam's a great product. It's lightweight. You can control the frequency response. The unique thing about our foam is that the cell structure is very consistent. That's why you get that nice curve, because the cell structure is very linear, very uniform, and very consistent. So always in acoustics, you want to stay with the open-celled foams for absorption. Okay, low ceiling. I see a lot of 7-foot ceilings. You have to realize that in your room, when you're sitting in your chair listening, the first reflection from your speakers is the floor, not the sidewalls. The next one is the ceiling, because those are the two surfaces you're sitting close to, if you think about it. Okay, so you're sitting on the floor and you're underneath the ceiling. So those are the two areas that you have to deal with. So those two surfaces have to be treated correctly. The sidewalls are responsible for image, definition, separation, central image focus, and issues like that. But these issues off the floor and the ceiling can confuse all those issues that the sidewall treatments is trying to correct. So everything has to work together. So watch your low ceiling situations. If you have low ceilings, you better have a low and small speaker, because you want to increase that distance. Don't put a 6-foot speaker in a 7-foot room. You can't do that. You can't, you know, deal with this kind of energy in that kind of volume and size. Okay? Get a lot of questions about, well, I have a suspended ceiling. What do I use for the calculation of the ceiling height when it comes to low frequency energy? Well, I guarantee you that low frequency energy, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90 cycles, could care less about your suspended ceiling. It's going to go right through your suspended ceiling. and it's going to go against the shell of the building. So when you do your calculations and do your measurement, forget about the suspended ceiling. It doesn't mean anything when it comes to low frequency technology and management. Floating floor. See a lot of this. People spend a lot of money on floating floors. What is a floating floor? It's a barrier. It's designed to keep energy in, keep unwanted energy from the outside from coming in. Do you really need it? You know, see, floating floors are expensive. Did you do some measurements? What is the noise level? What's the monitoring pressure levels in the room? Is it going to be 80, 83, 84, 85? Are you out in the country by yourself? Then you don't need a floating floor. Are you in a two-story building where the people below you are very sensitive to noise? Then you're going to need a floating floor. So a floating floor is a barrier. It's not a sound absorption technology. A lot of people get those mixed up. Well, I build floating floors, so therefore I have my low end under control. Nothing could be further from the truth. So a floating floor is a barrier technology. Just keep that in mind and make sure you need it because they're expensive to build. So those are some of the issues that we get in our inbox. If you have other questions, please don't hesitate to send them to us. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed our videos today, and if you did, we really would appreciate a thumbs up from you. If you have any questions or comments, you can go to the comment section, or you can go to our website, acousticfields.com, and fill out the contact form. Subscribe to our channel, our YouTube channel. We're now doing 2 videos a week. If you have some ideas for topics, you can submit those to us also. If you're having room issues, we have that free room analysis. You can click on the button below, and we'll compare your room to our database of 120 built rooms that we built and actually measured, and I guarantee you your room is in that database. So just click on the button below for the free room analysis. Thank you.